Hi, I'm Thaddeus Arroyo, Chief Information Officer at AT&T. Changes in technology led by advances in powerful mobile computing devices, connected to fast networks, and increasingly accessing services in the cloud are driving a major shift that's changing the way business does business. An influx of human talent into science, technology, engineering, and math fields is necessary to accelerate the innovation that will ultimately change companies, people, and society for the whole and for the better. But it's not just about numbers. It's also about diversity. Our greatest opportunity to innovate is through inclusion. A diverse team brings diversity of thought, approach, and understanding. In a global economy driven by innovation, advantage comes from the ability to create technology that is as broad and creative as the people it serves. Unfortunately, we're not tapping into the full power of diversity across technology industries. Even though women make up nearly half of the U.S. workforce and half of the U.S. college degree recipients annually, women hold only 25% of technology jobs. And these trends have remained constant for over a decade. I'm sitting in this red chair today because I believe all leaders in technology, from education and research to public and private enterprises, need to play a role in recruiting and retaining women in the fields of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. And we need more women role models in technical leadership positions who can guide other women into the field, with the hope of inspiring even greater ideas on how to advance this cause. I want to share a few of the initiatives we are pursuing at AT&T. The AT&T Foundation has given $90 million to support science, technology, engineering, and mathematics initiatives over the past 25 years, focusing on helping women and other underrepresented in the STEM fields. A few examples of benefiting organizations include the Girl Scouts, Girls Who Code, and Girls Inc. We feel this is important for inspiring the spirit of technological curiosity and the passion for continuous and lifelong learning. It's also important that we encourage and empower faculty at universities to not only recruit women to pursue a degree in the STEM field, but also provide mentoring through graduation. Students often cite the importance of an individual faculty mentor who support and influence their educational and career path. To support faculty that are making a difference on campuses, AT&T sponsors the National Center for Women in Information Technologies Undergraduate Research Mentoring Award. This award is given each year to undergraduate faculty for their outstanding mentorship, high-quality research opportunities, recruitment of women and minority students, and efforts to encourage and advance undergraduates in computing-related fields. Programs such as this are particularly important for women since they provide opportunities for personalized student-faculty interaction, a strong predictor of student retention. Internally at AT&T, more than 24,000 women are engaged in our diverse employee resource groups. The largest of these groups, called Women of AT&T, offers mentoring, development, networking, and community service opportunities to its 12,000 members. AT&T has also developed a Women's Leadership Council to build a pipeline of female talent across the company and to understand from a range of perspectives what AT&T can do to ensure we remain relevant and an employer of choice to women. These are just a few examples that I hope inspire even better ideas on how to align with this cause within your own organizations and institutions. This isn't only about equity. It's also about innovation, workforce sustainability, and the preservation of a technologically strong society. Together, we can make a difference.